All right, we're live. We're live, sir.
Okay, hi, everyone.
Ask if they can hear you.
Can you guys hear me? Seems to be a top issue. Although, usually you guys can hear me, you just can't see me well. Which I'm okay with. A soft blur? I don't know. I'll take it. I'll take a soft blur whenever I can get it, so.
Let's see.
What'd you title the thing?
I just said no BS live
stream. Oh, okay. So theoretically, I could talk about whatever I want to.
It sounds like they're not seeing anything, but.
You guys can.
There's a delay.
There's just a delay.
Woohoo, Prior Lake here.
Oh, Prior Lake in the house. Oh, yeah. Do the. What is that move, dance move? It's the only dance move I have. And I'm not even good at it. How depressing. Got one move. The other move.
I can see you and hear you.
Okay.
Alright.
That's a double whammy.
Cameraman
is a little stressed out.
We got 15 here.
We got 15 in the house?
Yeah.
That's exciting. I'm just organizing my,
I'm just getting your live stream open. You can get going.
I'm just organizing my props for today. Really quickly.
And do you want me to break out that chat thing like I did last time?
Sorry. Yeah, that worked better. Let's see. What goes with?
Do you want me to make the font a little bit bigger too?
Sure. My eyes are always kind of blurry. Except towards the end of the day. I don't know, ever since I had LASIK, it's... Right after LASIK, things were great, and then once winter came and it started getting really dry, my vision has gotten a little blurry in the morning. I'm not sure why, and I have a feeling once summer comes and it's not as dry out, my eyes won't be blurry or dry. That's what I'm thinking. Hoping. Although it's nice not to mess with contacts, because I always had issues with them. And then I was so cheap, I'd try and, like, extend the wear of the contacts a little bit too long where you shouldn't really be doing it. But, like, for toric, that's what I have, astigmatism, the contacts are so expensive. So, I was trying to be a little bit cheap by extending the wear of them. And then once I decided to do LASIK, it took me like 6 more months to actually schedule the appointment. Just because, I don't know, you're messing with your vision. So there's nothing ever good from there. Oh, someone from India is here. Wow.
There's 2 people from Italy.
Wow, Italy? India? All the eyes? Is Iceland in the house yet? What else do we have? London? Woohoo! Everyone, are you guys all at home just kind of... waiting for things to get better, hoping things will get better. That's kind of what I'm doing, so. Hoping, praying, wishing things will get better, so. Let's see, Netherlands, woohoo, lots of Europeans. Norwegian, yes, we got Norwegian. That's awesome. Los Angeles, Canada, Hawaii. I've been to Hawaii once, I went to Honolulu. It was hot there, but it was cool. It's very hot. Cyprus, wow. Were we in Cyprus?
Yep.
We were in Cyprus once. Cyprus is on the same island as Greece?
Stop.
Okay. Cyprus is on an island.
It is an island.
But wasn't there like a line where you had to cross into Cyprus? Am I thinking of something else?
It's split into two.
Okay. It is split. What's on the other half of Cyprus?
Cyprus.
Oh. Really? I don't know. I am really good at geography. I swear to God I am, but I'm better when I look at the map, so when I think about it in my head, it's all jumbled, but anyway. Yay, so Florida, Vegas, Long Island. We got lots of peeps here. I like that. This is awesome. Everyone from all over. And we're kind of just all sitting at home waiting for things to get better, and hopefully it does. So, I guess, you know what? I want to talk about my top 10 ingredient list, and then I also want to talk about the BS beauty brands use to sell skincare. But one thing I want to talk about first, so start thinking about your favorite ingredients. So some of these skincare companies, okay, there's a European cypress and a Middle Eastern cypress. That all makes sense. Germany's here, Toronto. This is awesome. We've got everyone from all over, so hopefully you guys are all staying safe and sane, trying to anyway. My friend, she just bought a giant jigsaw puzzle, so she's working on that now because she's unmarried, she's got a dog, and she's kind of self-quarantining, and so she's buying all these jigsaw puzzles and working on them. So, got Alabama. We have an occupation zone with Turkish cypress. I'm going to have to read about cypress tonight. It sounds like there's a lot going on there. Just
that's why we couldn't go across the UN border.
The UN border, okay. I knew when we were in Cyprus there was something that they wouldn't let us go to, so which was annoying because I just wanted to go there. So, so some of these skincare brands, so I'm stuck at home, and usually I get out every day, and I'm going a little bit crazy, so I'm probably doing a little bit more shopping online than usual. So I put an order at ColourPop last week. And then Sunday I got an email from them. We're closed in California. We're not considered exempt. So we either will delay your shipping or you can just cancel the order. So I thought that was interesting. And then on the same day I put an order in at Beautylish, which is also based in California in San Francisco. And their order should be here this week. So then I also got an email from the brand Maylove. They make the Glow Maker. That they are considered an essential business, so they won't be closing. So another one, Lord Jones, sent me an email a couple days ago as well, saying we are considered essential, we're not closing, so bring us your orders. Beautylish hasn't closed, and Youth to the People, also based in California, aren't closed. So what do you guys have any thoughts on that? I mean, are skincare brands essential? Should they be still open and filling orders? I don't know. I really don't know what I think about this. Usually I have a very strong opinion on almost everything. But when it comes to that, I'm like, well, in one regard, you know, they should stay at home to stop the spread of this thing. I'm calling it the thing because YouTube doesn't like talking about the thing. And then in one regard, some of these small companies like Maylove or Beautylish, maybe it's good that they're taking business and hopefully will stay open, but then wouldn't it be better for their warehouse people to be at home and not, I don't know, are they essential? Do you guys think? I know my view is totally skewed from what cameraman would say. He's like, they're not essential, you know, whatever. But for me, I don't know. I'm kind of torn on it. And there's other Net-a-Porter is a company, I guess they're not shipping in the U.S. at all. And actually they're having huge financial trouble. So this might actually take down their entire company, something like this happening. And especially if it goes on for a couple weeks or a couple months. I'm thinking a lot of the U.S. companies are saying, you know, we're closed for 2 weeks, we'll reopen April 3rd or whatever. I don't think anything's going to be reopening April 3rd. I just don't. So, anyway, I found that to be pretty interesting that some brands in California are totally closed, not filling orders, they're going to wait, and then some are essential. I mean, if one beauty brand company is essential in California, then wouldn't the other one be essential? Or maybe they make some special products that people need? I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. So, anyway, I'm interested. Let's see, I'm in Canada, and all of our marijuana shops continue to be open, are considered essential. Interesting. So, that Lord Jones, they kind of do the CBD stuff. So, I wonder if that's why. Because some of it's considered medical. I guess if I was on chemotherapy and I needed something like that, I would want them to remain open. Although my dad's been getting allergy shots for 40 years, And they just called him and told him, no allergy shots. So he's already getting sick from that. He's got such severe allergies.
And it's springtime.
And it's springtime right now. And all the mold and everything's coming out. So I just feel horrible for him because he is so sick. I mean, he'll be so sick that he won't be able to go to work. Because his sinuses are going to get bad and everything. So I guess allergy shots are not essential. But we've got our hydrating cream available. That's essential, but allergy shots not. So, let's see. Okay.
Did you have to kill to get all that toilet paper?
Some elderly ladies fist fighting. You know what? No, we were... I'm always a little bit paranoid. You guys have watched some of my videos. You've seen my backups. So, I don't just have 1 month backup or 2 months backup. I have 4 months backup of my favorite stuff. And I'm the same way with toilet paper and Kleenex. So somehow we scored that before any of this started even happening because I'm just, my dad's the same way. I think I learned from him. I'm just, you know what, I can't just buy one box of garbage bags. I have to have the three pack. And then once one of those rolls is gone, I got, but I'm just obsessive about just having everything. So, although maybe in a couple weeks I could trade that for like a car or something. And then I'll just use t-shirts and I'll have a new car. So, we'll see.
We'll install a bidet.
Yes, there we go. The French love them, so they've got a reason for it. So, yeah, somebody, Judy said, country open by Easter, not happening. I don't think so. It's crazy. So, yeah, Net-a-Porter is struggling. Their go-to e-commerce site is designer clothes. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I've heard. So they're not... They had a warehouse based in New Jersey for their U.S. shipping, and that's completely closed, too. So it'll be interesting to see. Maybe the clothing side of Net-a-Porter will stay open, and the beauty side will shut down, or maybe vice versa. But, I mean, with times like these, I don't see people buying a lot of designer clothes. I almost bought clothes the other day, and I'm like, you know what? I'm going to hold on to my money as much as I can, because who knows? You just... Everything is so uncertain right now. It's kind of frightening. So, yeah, skincare. So, New York Naturalista said, I think skincare is essential in terms of moisture barrier maintenance and for people with eczema, definitely. But most skincare isn't essential. But, yeah, if you've got eczema or psoriasis or skin issues, it is kind of unnecessary. And having a good, healthy skin barrier probably helps your immunity from a lot of other things versus having cuts or things like that. I mean, that's just another entryway for things to get in. So, we ended up with some unscented and unlotioned Kleenex. You know what? The lotiony Kleenex to me always drives me crazy, though. The Kleenex with the lotion on it, because it never feels like you get your nose really clean with that. And then you can't use it really for other things as much. That's what my mom loves. She always bought the super lotiony Kleenex. It's like, thanks, I'm just going to use a paper towel now, you know? So, online orders are essential for the businesses in order to survive. Yeah, that's very true. I don't want to see any... I'm sure there are going to be a lot of businesses that are going to end up closed because of this and just go out of business because they can't afford it anymore. So, as many of them that can stay open and survive, it will help the economy in the long run and people's jobs. I mean, people need jobs, so it's kind of scary. So I'm sure the price of skincare products will go up in price after all this is over. You think? Okay, so Terry K thinks the price is possible that the price of skincare products might go up. People might not be buying as much. And it has to be made up somewhere. My thought is maybe the price would go down just because people don't have as much money. There might be more competition in the brands that are left. I don't know. Nothing like this has ever happened before. So it could really go either direction or maybe it'll stay flat. Who knows? It'll be interesting to see because I'm sure there are some small brands that will be gone after this and probably some sales companies and things like that. So, kind of frightening. So, let's see. Okay. So, let's see. Toilet paper for a car. I know. What kind of car should I get, cameraman, for my toilet paper? How many rolls?
A Bentley.
A Bentley, you think? I'll take a Porsche. I don't know. Maybe a nice SUV for the dogs to sit in. Something like that. I'll take that. I don't know. I wish I would have stocked up on Purell, because that there was somebody that was selling. He had bought, I heard this, he bought 17,000 bottles of Purell and was going to sell them for $40 each. So I calculated the price he paid for all that Purell was like $30,000. And in the end, if he would have been able to sell them on Amazon for $40, he would have ended up making $750,000. But Amazon took his site down because it was price gouging. There are people selling Spam for $50 a packet. And my dad is, I love him. And I'm so much like him, but he hasn't had Spam, and he was telling me how his mom used to always make him Spam because they were talking about this listing of Spam for $50. He's like, God, I hated it. She'd make Spam, and it was like 2 times a week because they didn't have any money and things like that. And I'm like, I haven't had Spam, you know. And then the next day, he's like, I bought the $50 Spam, and I'm like, no. And I took his phone, and I canceled the order. Because I'm like, no, that's ridiculous. First of all, don't encourage people charging $50 for Spam. Second of all, you don't even eat Spam. You'll never eat it. Fourth, I have like 10 packages at my house that I'll never eat. So I canceled the order and brought him the Spam over. So now it'll be interesting to see how long that Spam sits there. He's never going to eat it. He didn't like it. He was telling me how much he didn't like it. But once it was like really expensive and wow, people are selling this. Like, he had to have it. It was
2 for $88 right now on Amazon.
$2 for $88. That's freaking insane. And I can't believe Amazon hasn't taken that down. It's ridiculous. You know what, though? It's all psychological. Like, my dad somehow thinks it's like, maybe it's going away or only the cool people have it. Fear of missing out. Like, if I don't buy this $80 Spam, tomorrow will be $400. And then I can't eat the Spam then. He's never going to eat it. I brought him over the packages. If he eats it, I'll keep you guys posted, but I think that Spam's going to sit there forever, so let's see. Someone from Israel under quarantine. What does everyone think about the Senate deciding on the stimulus package? It'll be interesting to see. Politics is interesting. You just never know what they're going to do, so let's see. Let's see what else we've got. I read that while makeup sales are down, skincare is up during this time. That's interesting. I kind of get it because skincare is, I mean, if you have dry skin or eczema or psoriasis or you just need sunscreen and vitamin C serum, you know, eyeshadow, not so much, but dry skin, cracked skin, irritated skin are real issues. Eyeshadow, not so much. So, anyway, let's see. The Shawnee Darden skincare line. Thoughts on it? Actually, it's pretty expensive, so that was my big thing with it. But the ingredients all look pretty good. I haven't had a chance to try any of them yet, but the retinol looks great. The texture reform looks great. The cleanser looks great. I don't really have any complaints. Just looking at it from the ingredients, they all look pretty good. So, I didn't really have any concerns looking through the ingredient list. Like, normally, like, if I looked through ingredient list and I saw denatured alcohol is, like, the second ingredient, I'd be concerned about it. Or just 80 fragrance ingredients, I'd be concerned about it. But they all look pretty good. And when Sephora has their sale, I'll pick up a few things. You can also check them out on Cult Beauty sells the Shawnee Darden line. And sometimes Cult Beauty will have 10, 15% off. So, it's also worth cross-checking the prices there. So, but overall, it looks pretty good. So, I'll definitely be picking some of that up as well. So, let's see what else we have here. I'm in Minnesota, yes. Let's see. Yes, somebody said, I forgot where you live. Minnesota. It's, you know what, with the thing going on, I didn't even notice, but this winter has been so mild. We had, like, a couple days of a lot of snow. And other than that, it's been pretty good, and I haven't even noticed because everything's around here is going crazy. So, yeah, I'll take it. Really, I didn't have, last winter at one point, both of the cars wouldn't start on the same day. And this year that didn't happen because it never got. Last year was like negative 30, I think. Was that what it was? Like negative 30 one day?
For a couple days.
For a couple days, negative 30. And both cars wouldn't start. I can't remember what was wrong with them. One of them we had to have towed because it was in a parking lot. We got it to Menards or something, and then it stopped working. So it's not like our cars are super old. I mean, they're not super new, but nothing that I would think. You know what? When it's negative 30 out, nothing works well. So I don't know. Okay, so how are people on Amazon sellers getting away with this behavior?
I just think there's so many people.
There's just, so many people just, they can't even keep track of it all.
I reported the spam listing, but...
Oh, cameraman reported the spam listing. Because that is price gouging. That's ridiculous. For how much do they really cost? Like $1, $2?
Yeah.
Maybe $3? Yeah. So for somebody taking something that sells for $3 and selling it for $50... which is like 15 times the price.
They're only asking 44 right now.
Oh, now it's 44. So it's like they're giving it away. That's ridiculous. I don't know. But you know what? Amazon will put down the hammer on people. Like, if you do something like that, they will delete your account. You'll never be allowed to sell on Amazon again. They're no joke to mess with. So, and I think that spam is like an cancelable order.
I think he canceled
it. But we were able to cancel it. But, like, the seller was saying, this is not cancelable, but I think they knew they were between a rock and a hard place. Like, if you won't cancel this $50 spam order, you're going to get in trouble. So, and negative 30 degrees Celsius. No, negative 30 degrees Fahrenheit. What is that in...
I'll look it up.
Yeah, there's a conversion. I learned it in chemistry, but I forgot it.
It's
like,
almost the same, though.
Yeah, at a certain point, they are pretty close to each other, I think, so.
Yeah, it's, here, let me.
Oh, poor Anne has been sick for 13 days now.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Yeah, distraction's good. You know, odds are it's probably just the regular thing, not the really bad thing. I can't say them, because I'll get in trouble from YouTube, but I was sick for a couple weeks, and it was just the regular thing. Thankfully, so I'm gonna hope that that's what it is. So definitely need a distraction.
30 below is 34 below.
Okay, 30 Celsius. 30 below Fahrenheit is 34 below Celsius.
Almost the same.
Almost, it is pretty close to the same. Hopefully it's just the regular thing. That's what I'm hoping, because it is, you know what, for some, even people that got shots for it, there was a really active strain that wasn't protected under the normal shot, so I'm hoping that's what you have. So keep me posted, hopefully.
What is, keep going.
Oh, sorry.
What does WTG mean?
What does WTG mean? W, what
way
the?
Way to go.
Way to go. Yes, and a wink.
Yay!
Let's see, okay. So, anyway. It's going to be interesting next few months, and I'll be doing live streams. You know, it'll be interesting to see as if after all this is done and gone, which might be a long time, will Sephora and Ulta have tester type things? Somebody was doing a live stream about just that, about the testers and things like that. You know, even before any of this happened, those testers, I've seen little kids in there messing with them. Just, they're gross. In general, unless you can get it from something that has a pour spout or like an airless jar or a pump bottle, you can get a sample like that. But like the lipsticks and stuff, I don't know if you can sanitize them that good that to really get rid of any of that. So I'm surprised before they all shut in the U.S. that they even had testers out, because someone was complaining on Reddit that they went into a Sephora JCPenney and the lady was following her around and she was upset. And this was like a day before they closed. I'm like, why are you in there? Just stay at home. But the lady was following her around to look to see if she was tested anything so she could go and sanitize it. But I don't even know if you can sanitize. I don't think anybody knows if you can really sanitize that good. So it'll be interesting to see if testing exists, or maybe they should just make more little samples, foil samples. Although they get pretty stingy on that, and it's not the most environmentally friendly thing. But maybe if someone's really serious about interested in a product, instead of just messing around trying them all, swatching them all, maybe they can get something like that, because it's much better than somebody getting sick from something. So, yeah. Let's see. I never touch the testers. Yeah, the testers are... You know, I've just seen so many cases, like when I was in Vegas, kind of before all this really started here, but there was a mom and she had like three kids with her and they're all little and they're all like the Tom Ford little section. They were messing with every single thing. And I'm not even saying that they had anything, but little hands can be germy. Big hands can be germy. I don't know. I just don't want to get sick. So anyway, let's see. I have $4,000 in toilet paper behind me. I'm rich. I always knew someday I'd be rich. That's our 401k. Yeah, that's our 401k. Our new car allotment, the next laptop, it's all right there. So
it's probably worth more than our
401k. It's definitely worth more than the 401k. That one's pretty sad shape. Really sad shape, so. Okay. Let's see. Okay. So, let me talk about my top 10 ingredients. And I'm interested if you guys have any top 10 or a specific favorite ingredient of yours. This one took me a while because I really wanted to narrow it down. Instead of just saying vitamin C, I wanted to pick my favorite form of vitamin C because there's so many of them. So, my first one was snail mucin. I love it. I can't get enough of the stuff. It's really helped my skin so much. And a couple of my favorite snail mucin products both happen to be Cosrx. Their eye cream. And their essence is great, and I just finished a jar of their snail mucin cream, so I don't have that with me. But that one's a favorite of mine. It does a good job healing skin, healing tissue, repairing tissue. There's also some growth factors in the snail mucin that are highly beneficial for healing wounds and things like that. Has a lot of regenerative effects just because of the chemical analysis of what's in snail mucin. There's collagen, elastin, elatin, glycolic acid, hyaluronic acid, and then natural antibacterial molecules in there. So I love snail mucin. If you haven't tried anything with it in there, try it, but try it in your evening routine because it's gooey, very gooey, especially the essence. But if you haven't, this is probably the starter product for snail products that I would recommend starting with, the Cosrx essence. No fragrance, no alcohol, lots of the good snail stuff. And if you have dry skin or irritated skin, this is a good one. So, and then their eye, I love their eye cream. I love that one too. So, yes. Does the It Cosmetics CC cream have snail mucin in it? I didn't know that, but I do like that one. Out of all the It Cosmetics, their CC cream is my favorite. So, but I guess I didn't realize that one had snail mucin in it. So maybe that's why I like it so much. Good eye cream for dry eyes. The snail mucin is great. I just finished up the Basha Triple Peptide Eye Cream. That one's really nice too. So I'm loving that one. I don't think I reviewed it, but I already finished it. So, but both those are great. So if you have dry eyes. I also like the Volition Beauty Helix Eye Gel. But it's more of an evening type product. Just because it is a little bit thick. So that one might be one to check out too. So. Huh. I didn't know it was a second ingredient in the CC cream. I'm going to have to go back and play with that some more. So. Huh. So Jenny commented, I bought the snail mucin from Amazon. My face broke out like crazy. I'm wondering if it was legit Cosrx snail mucin. You know, typically it should be anything but that happening, but I have heard of a few people. And sometimes I just wonder if for some people the cream or the snail mucin is just a bit too thick and maybe it clogs pores a little bit because it kind of sits on skin longer than a lot of other products. So...
Who was the seller on Amazon?
Yeah, who was the seller on Amazon? I know Amazon's done a really good job trying to get rid of illegitimate people selling it, but they're still out there. It's so hard. Once you get rid of one of them, another one shows up. So, I'm not sure. Worth checking out, though. So, let's see. Okay, yes, the Benton Snail Bee High Content Essence is wonderful. I love that one, too. That one's worth checking out. That one's a little bit lighter more of a gel type texture, so that one might be a little bit better for acne prone skin. Okay, so my second favorite ingredient is Adapalene. And in the U.S., you can get it without a prescription at a strength of 0.1%. Yes, 0.1%. There's several brands that make it. La Roche-Posay makes one. Proactive makes one. Indifferent makes one. Pick out the one that's cheapest because all three formulas are identical. There are no difference at all, even though the prices tend to be between $28 and about $37 at the high end. So get whatever one you can find on sale because they're all the same. But I love Adapalene. It's a really great topical retinoid that is now available in the U.S. over the counter, which is really nice. It really does a good job helping prevent breakouts, helping prevent blackheads, whiteheads, helping with clogged pores, preventing it, helps kind of skin cell turnover. And if you have acne-prone skin, I found it to be rather gentle to start out with. I've tried Tretinoin. I've tried that, and that one instantly made my skin peely and dry. Although with all of these things you want to build up to using it daily, but I just found it to be more drying, whereas Adapalene I found to be a bit more gentle. So it's probably all depends on the person, and maybe this one isn't quite strong enough for more difficult breakouts, but the Adapalene is a good one to start out with, especially if you're in the U.S. and get it without a prescription, because that saves some money right there. And probably right now, are dermatologists considered essential or not? I have no idea. If allergy shots aren't essential, I don't know. So that'll be interesting. So does cameraman get bored with his job?
Yes,
he does. Usually the dogs come down and entertain him or something, but you know what? The dogs have not been very active in my downstairs videos lately, so I'm a little bit disappointed with them. Whenever they come downstairs, I think they're ready to go to Dad's house, so they just go and sit by the door and wait to get loaded into the car to go to Dad's house to check on the Yorkies. So, yes, you do get bored, though. Sorry. Bidet is sounding better and better. I tried one when we were in France, and it was like a watery... I couldn't figure it out. I must be a little bit off. But it was like a... there must be a trick to using it. I don't know. But maybe I'll have to learn. I guess we'll see, so... New York Naturalista, I did like the Volition Beauty Eye Cream. It seemed a little silicone-ish. It is kind of silicone-y. But if you have very dry eyes and use it in your evening routine, for me, it worked a little bit better. But it is... If you don't like that silicone-y, dimethicone-type feeling, it's probably not the best eye cream. But, yeah. A good one, so... Let's see. Okay, so I did Adapalene. So I'll go on to my next favorite ingredient. And that is... Can anybody guess? Anybody? Okay. Starts with an S and ends with a D, I think. Yes. Well, it's two words. Okay. Salicylic acid. And I've got a couple products that I love that contain salicylic acid. The Tula Acne Clearing and Correcting Gel, this is the old packaging. They changed it now to a blue bottle. This one contains 2% of that, and it's really good. I tend to use it on days when my skin is more dry or sensitive. The Paula's Choice 4% BHA treatment is also a good one. And a newer product that I like with it is the Tula, what do they call it? The Breakout Star Oil Free Acne Moisturizer, which has 2% salicylic acid in it. So on days when my skin is really dry, this is the one I use. But anyway, so salicylic acid is beta hydroxy acid. It helps treat many causes of acne. It's also mainly used and known as an exfoliant, helping shed dead skin cells in a way similar to how skin acts when we are younger. It has the ability to penetrate into the pore lining and exfoliate the inside of the pore as well as on the surface of skin. It is especially effective in reducing breakouts, blackheads, and whiteheads. So... It's a very good ingredient. And I prefer beta-hydroxy acid over most of the alpha-hydroxy acids, especially if you're someone that has If you're prone to, breakouts or acne, I think going with the salicylic acid is a great option. If you're not, there's nothing wrong with alpha-hydroxy acids, but salicylic acid is the main one I go with. So, for some people, it just doesn't work well. Some people have better luck with alpha-hydroxy acids. There's nothing wrong with that. But I think, probably when I get older, I have a feeling alpha-hydroxy acids might be a bit better. So, I guess I'll see. Although I am older now, so. The Ordinary alpha-hydroxy, beta-hydroxy acids. Jennifer, hi Jennifer. She says she wishes she could get along with beta-hydroxy acids, but she can only use lactic and glycolic acid. Yeah, some people, it's interesting. For me, I find alpha-hydroxy acids to be a bit more drying than the beta-hydroxy acids. I have no idea why. Maybe it's just the strength. As long as they're a good pH. I don't know. Anyway. So, let's see. I love Paula's Choice BHA toner. That's an awesome one, too. Oh, and top three. Snail mucin, niacinamide, and beta-hydroxy acids. So, she guessed three that are on my list, which is pretty impressive. So, niacinamide. Jennifer is obsessed with niacinamide. Niacinamide is so good. You know what? I'll talk about it in a second. Niacinamide, but let's see. Oh, Chris Michael, I'm so proud of how far you've come on YouTube. I subscribed when you had 500 followers, and now you have 30,000. That's Yay. Incredible. That's awesome. Cool. I can't. Thank you for being there early. Because when I started out, any of you remember my first videos where it was just my hands? I'm like, I don't want to show my face. People are going to say nasty things if I show my face. And that just kind of evolved. But the second setup, I looked at an old video from the second setup, and the camera angle is like looking up, and it just wasn't the best look. And then we had the lighting issue for like probably 100 videos, where it looked like, I had like the most caked on mud on my face. And everyone would comment, how much bronzer are you using? I'm like, I didn't even put any on. I didn't even put any bronzer on. I don't know why I look bronze. But I think we got to figure it out now.
Maybe.
I'm sure in like 3 months I'll look back and be like, God, that was all bad. That was all wrong. The camera angle does not work. Or maybe I'll lose weight because I haven't been having my Culver's ice cream every night. I haven't been having my Starbucks lattes. I should be losing weight. Although now I'm just into making cookies every day. So I can find a niche. So, you deserve 1 million. I'll take 1 million. If we get 1 million, I gotta get a new countertop, though.
That's a deal.
Okay. Let's see. Okay, so let me get on to my next one, which is, it starts with a P and ends with an S, and it is propolis. Propolis is a newer ingredient to me, kind of. It's one I found in the last year, and I really love it. It helps so much with my dry neck and my dry face. And it is great. So it's a brownish resinous substance collected by honeybees from tree buds or other botanical sources. It has some serious benefits for skincare. It's smoothing, moisturizing, and also has oil control properties. It is rich in flavonoids and phenolic compounds. I'm not saying that right, but. And is also a well-documented antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, antifungal, and antiviral properties. Its potent antibacterial and anti-inflammatory properties have been shown to expedite the healing process of wounds and sunburns. So, if you haven't tried anything with propolis in it, it's amazing. So, I finally got around to trying the Skin Food Royal Honey Propolis Essence. And this one is awesome. I love it. I'm so glad you guys told me to try it, because I'm so glad I took you up on it, because it's a nice one, and it's more affordable than some of the other options. The Wish Trend one I really like, but it's a little bit more expensive. The bottle's a little smaller, and it just doesn't go as far. But the Skin Food one is awesome. I love that one. And the Dr. Circle? What is this one called? Royal Vita Propolis? I got a set where you get like three bottles of them. So now I'm on to my second bottle, and I'm really loving this one, too. So any of these ones are awesome Propolis products. And to be honest, I don't know what was going on with my neck for years. It was always dry, cracked, peeling, irritated, red, sore. Couldn't use almost anything on it. And Propolis healed it within, like, a couple weeks. So I had that problem going on for years. And I don't know if it was, like, a small, like, bacterial thing going on. For years, it was always had that problem. And then within a couple weeks of Propolis, boom, it was better. And now it looks normal for the most part. So, and I can almost wear makeup on it now. So, Propolis, love it. If you haven't tried it, go for it. It's well worth it. You'll be so happy you did. So, yeah, the Skin Food is my fave essence serum ever. Yes, it's awesome. Yeah, you were the one. Jennifer is one of the ones that was telling me to try this. So, thank you. I'm so glad I did. It is going to be in my arsenal forever. So, I'm interested to see if they come out with any, like, a Propolis toner. Maybe they already have it. The Cosrx Propolis toner is really good, too. I couldn't find it this morning, though. I was looking around for it everywhere, so. Let's see. Never used Propolis, but I've heard it can be good for acne-prone skin. Do you know anything about that, Sarah? It can. It's great because of its antibacterial properties. It really can help with breakouts. So if you have any breakouts, if I ever get some, I just kind of spot. Sometimes I'll spot apply it. Or if my skin's feeling dry, then I'll just apply it over my whole skin. So I'd highly recommend Propolis for that. Definitely. If you haven't tried it, I think you'll be very happy. And it's super easy to fit into your routine. And it really leaves your skin feeling nice and soft and hydrated too. So all the way around, it's awesome. So, okay, I'm sold. I have to try it. I should be a salesperson for something. I never got to do anything in sales, really. Although my first job was, I did credit verifications for any bank that did, like, check. Any bank that opened up checking accounts. So they would call me and I'd type in the social security card number. And I'd be like, okay, this person has, like, 80 bankruptcies. And then just tell the information, make them decide. Sometimes they'd be like, this social security was issued 100 years ago and the person died. I'd be like, okay, thanks. And sometimes I wonder if they still open up the credit card. Because once in a while I get something where the social security number is registered to someone that is dead. Anyway, that's my first job. It was horrible. It's like, beep, beep, and I'd be on the phone. Beep, beep. Over and over and over for like 12 hours at a time. And you couldn't eat, you couldn't do anything, you couldn't drink, you just had to sit at that little cubicle. That was, you know what, now it's probably all done online. So now I've been outsourced. Oh well. I'll take it. The Skin Food Serum and Cosrx Snail Mucin work wonders. The I'm From Honey Mask, love that. And Mugwort Masks are amazing. I love the I'm From Honey Mask. I'm still testing the Mugwort Mask. Mugwort is an interesting ingredient. I'm not quite sure on it. For me. So, it's got a smell to it. Like an earthy smell. I don't know if I can get past it, but my lips are going through hell. Any lip balm recommendations? So, the one I just finished, the Drunk Elephant Lippy, I love that. Lincoln finished it for me. Lincoln loves to eat lip balm. That one's a good one. Smith & Cult CBD Lip Mask. I love that one, too. That one's a really good one. The Tatcha Kisu Lip Mask is also really nice. And then the Skin Iceland Berry Lip Fix. I love that one, too. And I'm trying to think. There's one more. The Milk Makeup Kush Lip Balm is really nice for the most part, but it has a bit of a texture thing to it that I'm not sure I love for the daytime use, but I'll use it at night. I keep it on my nightstand. So if anybody else has any lip recommendations, go for it. What was the other one? There's one more that I love. I can't think of it. The Smith & Cult one is really good, though. I love that one. I'm trying to think. The Biosance Rose Squalane Vegan Lip Balm is also really good. If you like a good lip mask. For lip balm, I like the Kanuka Lip Balm. It's got like honey in it, I think. The Kanuka Lip Balm. It's like orange cap, white tube. So Alginus Lip Balm is also great. I love that one. I use that one when I do masks. The Fresh Sugar Lip Balm is good. That one is good too. The Fresh, if you haven't tried the Fresh Sugar Lip Balm, everyone should try that at least once in their lives. Because it's really good. It's pricey, but you know what? Your lips are important. So, Laneige, they have, their lip mask is great. Their jelly, what is it called? Like the Jelly Pop lip, I can't think of it. Laneige, it's like in a tube, and they've got like different flavors. I think it's like the Pop Lip, Laneige Lip Pop, maybe? Something like that. So those are good ones. Yeah, if you haven't tried the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask, that one's a good one, too. Although, don't get the apple one. Get the berry version if you can. That's my thought. So, if I could only choose one skincare line for 1 month, which would you choose? So right to the top of my mind comes First Day Beauty because I couldn't live without their Ultra Repair Hydrating Serum for 1 month. So that would be one of them. I'm trying to think if anything else comes to mind. Drunk Elephant, but their protein is great, but I'm not sold on their vitamin C and their sunscreens are kind of thick. So I think it would be First Aid Beauty. The PCA Hyaluronic Acid Lip Balm. I haven't tried that one, but I think I have it. I'm going to have to pull that one out. I think it would be First Aid Beauty. Now they've got a really good sunscreen too. So that's a hard choice. Questions like that are, you know, when I review something, I'll always get a comment. Would you like this one or this one if you could only choose one? It's like, I can never only choose one. That's why I've got so much stuff, because I can never eliminate down to one thing, ever. But I don't know. Anyway, I'm ridiculous when it comes to that stuff, so. $50K was for the new countertop. You know what? Okay. It is $50K, but if I reach 1 million, I think I get new kitchen countertops and a new bathroom countertop. What about that?
I like 1 million for the countertops alone.
Yeah. Yeah, no. I want a whole new kitchen for 1 million.
Yeah, I'll do a new kitchen okay. for
1 million. Let's see.
These people, why do they remember these things?
They're not. Why do you remember these things? Let's see. I've never tried First Aid Beauty. I need to try it. Yes. If you haven't tried First Aid Beauty, their Ultra Repair Hydrating Serum. It's the bomb. I love it. It's probably the longest single product I've been using in my entire life. So, let's see. Okay. Want a Beauty Pie review? I'll add that to my list. Maybe I can buy them right now? I wonder if they're fulfilling orders. I'll check it out. Hi from Paris! Oh, I love Paris. Paris is so neat. So. Are you quarantined too? Oh, I shouldn't have even said that, should I?
That's alright.
Oh no. YouTube's gonna yell at me. I hate when they yell at me.
Not officially, but everything's shut down.
Okay. What?
They asked if you were quarantined.
Oh, am I? I'm self-quarantined. The only thing I do is I leave to go to my dad's house to check on the Yorkies. That's it. Although, there's a bread store that makes great cookies, and they are doing curbside pickup. So I'll be good there. Other than that, that's about all I'm doing. I had a huge food order from Target come yesterday, and everything came except for any of the meats. But I'm getting creative with making things, so I'm staying fed somehow. Okay, so my next favorite ingredient, number 6, is niacinamide. And the new Josie Maran Niacinamide Cleanser, I'm really enjoying this one. The Q&A Niacinamide Toner, I love the Good Molecules Niacinamide Toner, but I couldn't find it today. I looked for a half an hour. I don't know where it is. I looked at my shelf. I looked in the G bin. I looked in my... I don't know where it is. I know I didn't finish it. Maybe I did finish it. Anyway, I looked for it forever. And another one I like, the Awake Glow Pill Serum. This one contains a lot of niacinamide as well. And then the new Paula's Choice, if you're really solid on niacinamide and your skin can handle it, the 20% is pretty darn strong. So niacinamide is great. Also known as vitamin B3 and nicotinic acid. Niacinamide is very effective skin restoring ingredient that offers multiple benefits for aging skin, also acne prone skin. It helps with the appearance of pore size, uneven skin tone, fine lines, dullness, and also can help with the good skin barrier. Let's see. Yeah, so niacinamide, love it. And I think I missed number 5. I'll go back to that one. But do you guys have a favorite niacinamide product? Because it's in a lot of products. But now I'm noticing more and more just niacinamide serums. I'm trying to get my hands on the 4-3 Beauty niacinamide serum, but it's sold out at Ulta now and ColourPop's not delivering. So once I get that, I'll review that one. But that was one I've been trying to get my hands on forever. And now I'm finally trying out a lot of the 4-3 Beauty products. I think it was Jennifer that was asking me about it, like probably several months ago, when I was going to review any 4-3 Beauty. Is that right? I'm pretty good with remembering things. So anyway, I'm finally trying a lot of their stuff out. So FYI. But anyway, the Polish Joy is pretty strong. My skin doesn't handle the 20% as well, but I'll mix a little bit with another serum, and that one seems to work pretty good. So, the Paula's Choice Niacinamide 10%, that's a good one. My skin handled that one so much better. The 20% just seems to be slightly drying. So, anyway, I've been using the Ordinary Niacinamide 10% for a while, but the Revolution Skincare 15 Niacinamide Serum is at... I'm trying to remember if I bought this Revolution Skincare Niacinamide. I think I have it. And I'm going to have to play with that one, too. I think 15% for me might be my sweet spot, because 10% seems to be not quite enough, but 20% is a little bit too much. So I'm going to have to go through my shelves and look and see if I can find that one.
Hey, Snowdraft asked, what's inside that little pink bottle behind you?
Pink
bottle. The other way.
This one?
Yeah.
It's empty right now. But I travel with these. Especially when I go up to the cabin.
Tell them they can buy them.
You can buy them online.
With the bag.
With the bag. So check them out. I fill them up when I go to the cabin with shampoo or conditioner or body wash. Because I'm pretty loyal to my shampoo. Sometimes I'll bring the little foil packets with. So I should fill that one up with something. Maybe, you know what I should fill that up with is like peanut butter, and then I can get the dogs to come down here to be on the video. What do you think about that? I think that's a good idea. Have I ever heard of Fleur and B and their products? I have not, but I'm going to have to check that brand out. Do I have a pen? I'm going to write that down. That and Beauty Pie. I'll check those out. I've got all the time in the world to shop, and it's very dangerous. Fleur and B. Okay, I'm going to check that out. Can I review the Bioderma mattress serum? It's a single dose repair fluid, has niacinamide. I'll have to check that one out too. I've got some time to shop, so I'll check that one out as well. I've been meaning to try more Bioderma products, actually. So I'll have to pick them up. The Verso niacinamide serum, that one's good too. I have that, and I forgot about that. It's weird, when I was thinking niacinamide, the only thing I could think of is good molecules, niacinamide toner. Where the heck is it? I must have finished it. I'm kind of annoyed. Anyway, I did a comparison video of 3 different niacinamide serums and the Revolution. Okay, yes, you're right. I thought I had that one. You know, sometimes I have so much stuff, I can't remember it. Isn't it? It's ridiculous. I need to get better about that, so. Okay, so the fifth product or favorite ingredient that I was going to talk about was not vitamin C, L-Ascorbic Acid. And some of my favorites, the Timeless, they use L-Ascorbic Acid. The Dr. Brenner vitamin C serum, it is almost identical to SkinCeuticals, except it has a little bit more L-Ascorbic Acid in it. And then I'm on my second of the Paula's Choice C15 booster, and another one I like, the Isn't Tree C Niacin, which has both vitamin C and niacinamide. So this one, you can tell, has got a lot of use. This one is finished. This one is about half through, and this is my second bottle of this. So I think I love these. The Wish Trend Vitamin C Serum's great. There's a lot of great ones. But these are currently in my top favorite. So Timeless is pretty good for oily skin, yes. It has a light texture. So some, you know what, the other one, if you have very oily skin, the Isn't Tree is also really good because it's super light. And the Dr. Brenner's a little bit more oily. So if you have oily skin, I would probably recommend either the Timeless or the Isn't Tree, C-Niacin. And the Timeless has more vitamin C in it than the Isn't Tree, so they're both good. I'll review the Beauty Stat one soon. That's my next one I'm going to be trying as well. So the Glow Recipe Vitamin C Serum is amazing. That's the one with the pineapple. I love that. I have that already as a gift for my sister-in-law. She's probably not watching this.
No.
But we didn't get to celebrate birthdays because we're all self-contained. Just missed out on a lot of birthdays this month. So Osmosis Vitamin C. I'm going to have to check that one out. I haven't tried that.
You got to go back up.
Go up. Let's give cameraman a shout out.
Yes.
Woohoo! Woo woo!
Can't miss the comments about me.
Oh, I missed them all?
I thought you were going to miss it.
Oh, well, I can't miss that. How are the dogs? Where are they? Do you see if you can get Ike or Lincoln down here?
Yeah, I'll see what I can do.
They're both kind of. When we're not upstairs, Lincoln lays on the couch like a cat and looks out the window. And then Ike kind of just checks out the kitchen to see if there's anything on the countertop. So, Lincoln is 3 and Ike is 8. The great 8. Ike was so little as a puppy. Let's see if we can get him down here. Lincoln! See, I gotta fill up. Come here, Lincoln! Lincoln, come here! Come say hi quick. Lincoln! Okay, that's it. Lincoln! He loves to sit on my lap sometimes. He's knocked over my bag of skincare products. There we go. He's probably going to sniff them all now. Lincoln! I guess Ike's not coming down, huh?
No.
Well, we got Lincoln. He's special. He's going to be 4 in October. So, this summer, I'll have to do some videos of them swimming. They love to swim at my dad's house. They'll chase the ball into the pool.
Ike's 8, right?
Ike's 8, that's what I said.
Oh.
I think, yeah, he's 8.
Yeah.
He's up there, so. I have an 11 and 13-year-old Shih Tzu and Bigapoo? I haven't heard of that brand. That breed. Is it like a poodle and a...
I'm lost on the chat, but...
Bigapoo. Is it a poodle and a... Is there a Bianese? Beagle? I'm going to have to Google that, too. Oh, you got a medal. Here's a medal for the cameraman. It's the only medal you have. Sorry. Let's see. Okay, this is a serious dermatologist think tank. I love you, but exactly how many layers of skincare is your typical night? Too many. But you know what? Somehow it all soaks in. Because by the morning, my face is dry. It's probably 20 layers. You know what? Next week I'll do it where I'm going to see how many layers I can do. And try and make the most high maintenance routine ever. Because all I have is time. So maybe I'll see if... I wonder if there's a world records for how many layers. There might be. So I'm going to try that. But yeah, it's out of control. And it's getting worse. The longer I have to sit in the bathroom, the more elaborate I can make it. It's just ridiculous. So, let's see. Okay. Dog thinks he's a cat. Yes, that's what he does. He just lays on the back of the couch in the sun. I have a plant there, and once in a while I'll catch him like... plucking at the leaves, so not gonna go over well. Let's see. Bigapoo. Truth Treatment Transdermal Sea Balm. I'm gonna have to add that to my list. Bigapoo. I wish we could send pictures over this.
I can. Here.
You can. Do you want to Google it?
Well, I just got my computer screen.
Oh. I'm gonna have to Google that. Okay. typical German short hair pointer. They do what they want. I'm impressed you got the GSP down. That's impressive. Let's do a world record layers of skincare. I think we should. I'm going to do that. Did you Google it? Oh, yes. That's what I was... You know, I think that's what my brother has.
I already put it up.
Oh, I just see it on your computer.
There. No,
yeah.
Their computers.
Isn't that what Derek has? I think that's what my brother has.
I thought his was big. No, he's got a golden doodle.
Oh, golden doodle. Oh. It kind of looks like a miniature version of my brother's dog.
It does.
They're so cute. I wish I could have like 100 dogs.
Are they hypoallergenic?
Are they hypoallergenic? Probably. It looks like it just from the picture. Yeah. What do I think about the Benton Snail Bee Serum? I love it. It's awesome. It's a good one. Benton has a tendency to be pretty good with their products. They're all pretty affordable. And mostly fragrance-free and alcohol-free. So that one's a good one. I like that. I'm trying to think if I've reviewed that one yet or not. If I haven't, I will do that. So, the BioBear. Yeah, that's the other one I wanted to try, is the BioBear Vitamin C. I'm adding that to my list. I just wish Vitamin C didn't go bad so fast. Because I could go through, I could have, 15 open at any given time. But I can't. But I would love to, anyway. I saw one lady on YouTube who did a really crazy routine. She applied TCA peel onto her neck after microneedling it. Oh! That just brings tear to my eyes just thinking of that, how painful that would be. There are people that will microneedle their neck, but I can't. Oh! I feel like calling 911 to report that lady. She's gonna end up in a bad spot. So, lots of the doodle breeds look very similar. They do. I wonder if I could... You know, I saw this dog I really wanted to adopt, but... I don't know. Between the two big dogs and the four Yorkies, but... He lost his back legs in an accident. He had, a little cart. He was so cute. I still want to get him for my brother-in-law. If he's watching. He doesn't have a dog yet, but...
I'm sure he's watching.
I'm going to get his next rescue dog. So... Let's see. What is the most I've ever spent on a skincare product? Trying to think. That's a good one.
Yeah. What is the most?
I haven't gone too crazy. I've never bought the full bottle of SkinCeuticals because I usually just would take my mom's when she was halfway through with it. It's probably something by Tatcha. I'm thinking. I'm going to have to think about that one. That's a hard question.
You just don't want to answer because I'm here.
That's true. I don't want you to hear the answer. Skincare is an expensive hobby. It is. Oh, they want to see your skincare routine.
I'll pull it up for him.
Oh, he's going to pull up his skincare routine. This will be interesting.
Dang it, almost there.
This is about it, too. Can you guys see it yet?
I guess. Yep, that's it.
There we go. That's the truth, too. I'm not even kidding. I keep trying to put, little hints in his drawer, like the Clinique men's line, or I'll leave a little bit. And have you used any of that?
No.
No, not yet. Of course. Oh, someone asked what I think of Lemur Skincare. Very good time with that question. It's like you read my mind, because I've got a video coming up this week about it. So stay tuned for that. I can't say anything else, so you just have to wait. Vintner's Daughter. I haven't tried anything from Vintner's Daughter, although I thought about it. What was the other? May Lindstrom, they're really expensive, too. I thought about when they were on sale, but I didn't do it. Irish Spring. No, yes, Irish Spring. You know what? Ike loves the smell of Irish Spring, and he'll try and go and take the bar of soap later on after he's done and eat it. I have to keep him out of the shower because of that. Somehow you're... Oh, they're so cute. Oh, that's Ike. He's so cute. Oh, that's Lincoln with his sweater on. I got Lincoln and Gertie matching sweaters. So Gertie's the smallest Yorkie, I'll have to put a picture of her up tonight. So she had a little red sweater, and Lincoln has a red sweater, and they look so cute together, so... He sounds hot, though, even if he uses Irish Spring. Somehow you can get away with it. I don't know. If I did that, my face would probably fall off.
I'm putting my favorite picture of Ike up.
Aww. That's Ike with his sweater. That's he had a small injury in that picture.
Yeah, that's when he cut himself on the barbed wire.
Yeah. Poor Ike. He's such a hard worker. He really is. He's obsessed with working. And not all of it is for good. Okay, so I'll try and keep going.
Oh, wait. Oh. Here's Ike with...
Oh, FabFitFun. That's what he thought of FabFitFun that month. They must have included some food in that box or something. So, okay, so my other... I've got three more favorite ingredients. Peptides is up there on the list. And the buffet is awesome.
You're still doing the list.
I'm getting through the list. I've got to. Is that it for peptide? No, one more. So these are some of my favorite peptide products. If you haven't tried the Ordinary Buffet yet, you should. It's a bargain for what you get. Full of good stuff. Affordable. Fragrance-free. Alcohol-free. It's a bargain. Ike is so cute. He is. And naughty. The Proteini I love. The Peter Thomas Roth Peptide 21 is also great. There's a lot of things with peptides in them, but I love peptides because they are amino acids, which really are the building blocks of your skin and your face and your infrastructure. So we need peptides. They really help with the keeping a healthy skin barrier. They help with firmness. They help with wrinkles, texture changes, and things like that. So peptides have a lot of research showing that they're very good for skin. They help revitalize skin, help revive aging skin. So if you don't use peptides in your routine, add something with peptides in it because a little bit will go a long way. So if you haven't tried The Ordinary, the Good Molecules Peptide Serum is great too. And what was the other? I did a copper peptides. I really like the Buffet Plus Copper Peptide Serum. It is just a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. Copper peptides are probably good for skin, but I'm not necessarily sold that they are better than any other peptide on its own. I'm still kind of making up my mind on that. But copper peptides are so fussy, so I'm really, really doing some thinking on the peptide topic. So, yes, I do need to do a full review of the Niode copper peptide gel because I just did my first impressions and I've got some more thoughts since then, so I'll add that to my list. I've got a good list of assignments, so that's good for me. Let's see. You know what? Can I do the best peptide products? I will. A top 10 maybe? Peptide list? I can't believe I haven't done that. Maybe top 2. I'll see if I can get to 10. I have a feeling I can. Because there's a lot of good peptide products out there. The buffet is certainly going to be on there. So if you haven't tried that one, it's well worth it. What is the best time to use peptides? I use peptides in both my morning and evening routines. Any routine I do, somehow peptides are in there. If it's a peptide serum or a peptide moisturizer, they're in there. So I use them all the time. Although I'm out of control with stuff. So I would say if you are going to choose one routine, I would probably use peptides more so in your evening routine where it can really soak in and help with the building blocks of skin. That's what I would probably do. So the Acure Radically Rejuvenating Whipped Night Cream is also a good one. That'll be on my top 10 peptide list as well. Do I have a review of the Drunk Elephant Proteini? I do. It's a crazy routine. Can you Google it, Joe, and link to it?
What's that? Oh, it's one of your videos?
Yeah, the Drunk Elephant Proteini.
Yeah.
So, do I know of any good K-Beauty product with peptides? I'm trying to think. I think this, the The Claire's Midnight Blue Calming Cream has some good peptides in there.
What did you want me to find?
The Drunk Elephant Proteini.
Okay.
I'm trying to think if there's anything else, key beauty, that pops up in my head. Neogen just came out with a new peptide serum, which is half off right now at Style Korean. I'm picking that one up. But their shipping changed. It used to be like free shipping on like $50.
Was this it, Sarah?
Yes, because I remember my shirt matched the jar. So that one looks interesting. So I'm going to have to try that one. The Purito Buffet. I'm trying to think of the Purito. Yes, the Purito Buffet. I'm trying to think of what else I can think of. I'll have to think. Nothing else is coming to mind. So I'm sure there are a ton of them. Anyway, I'd love to see if you would review the Strivectin Triphase Daily Glow Toner. I have that, and that's one thing I've been meaning to review as well. I'll add that to my list. That one's been a hard one to get to review because it's not my favorite. Just so. But I'm working on it, so. Anyway. Okay, so. I've got two more. Okay. I've got two more ingredients. Marula oil. Out of all the oils, there's really no oil that's better than the other. I just found marula oil works best for my skin. I found some oils have a tendency for me just to clog my pores. But as long as you have a good oil that's not a citrus oil and non-fragrant, it's good for your routine. So if you have a favorite like argan oil, some people love marula oil. There's so many different oils without fragrance. So for me, I've just found the marula oil is my favorite and works just great for my skin. Squalane oil for me has a tendency to clog my pores a bit, but my skin just loves marula oil. So, but none of them are better than the other. It's just a kind of a personal preference. I just find the marula oil to be a little bit light. It soaks in quickly. It's pretty friendly for acne-prone skin, so I love it. It's a good one. It's moisturizing. It won't clog your pores. It contains fatty acids that mimic the outer layer of skin. It also contains antioxidants such as vitamin C, vitamin E, and flavonoids. And it's a surprisingly non-oily oil. It's quickly absorbed into the skin without leaving you feeling greasy. So, that one's a favorite. And then, my number 9, Centella Asiatica Extract. And I found, for me, this is my favorite Centella Serum. It's the Purito Centella Serum. And I just really like this one. It's surprisingly hydrating. It's got a lot of the good stuff in there. And as long as you pick up the one that says unscented, it has no fragrance in it. They have two versions of this one. One has a fragrance and the other one doesn't. The one in the green bottle has fragrance. This one in the clear bottle is fragrance-free. So Centella Asiatica is super calming. It's really been proven. It's been used for years topically and actually internal, like as a vitamin-type calming ingredient. So Centella Asiatica on my top 10 list. Love it. It kind of has been kind of a hyped ingredient. And it's deserving of the hype. And I don't think it's going to go away now that it's really become popular. I don't think it's going to go away anytime soon. So, Centella Asiatica, very calming and healing. Very good if you have irritated skin that's dry. If you're prone to like eczema or things like that, it's a great ingredient. Or if you're prone to rosacea, it can also be very calming and anti-inflammatory. That's a good ingredient worth checking out. And my number 10 ingredient is, I'm going to mispronounce it, Guaiazulene, which is in the Claire's Midnight Blue Calming Cream. Neogen came out with their Surmedic line, which contains azoline. And the Guaiazulene is a dark blue crystalline hydrocarbon derived of azoline, the blue colorant constituent of chamomile oil. It's a great ingredient. It's used in shampoos and other hair care products. It also has anti-inflammatory properties and also can help soothe the scalp and hair follicles. Very good anti-inflammatory, hydrating, calming, and wonderful for skin, especially dry skin, irritated skin, and I love it. So the Claire's would be my top choice. I'm tippy-toeing around their Sermetic line because some of them don't have fragrance in them and some of them do. So now that they're on sale, I'm going to have to check out a bit more of them because this toner I like. It's a foam toner, which is weird, but it has a little bit of fragrance. So I wasn't super excited to see that, but the Claire's is fragrance-free now. It wasn't when it first came out, but now that it's been out for a while, it is totally fragrance-free. So certainly worth checking out. So yeah, it's a good ingredient. There's like a gel. I can't remember what brand made it. Guaiazulene was the name of it. Is it like May Coop or Ra or something? May Ra. Anyway, Guaiazulene, well worth checking out. Very calming. And sometimes that blue color is just soothing at night. I don't know. It's a little strange, but it does soothe. I haven't found any hair products with it in there, but I'm going to have to Google it now because my scalp is always dry and especially in the wintertime, it's even worse. So, the Soonjung Barrier Cream is amazing. I think I just picked that one up, and I think it finally just came. So I'm going to have to play with that one tonight. So, Claire's Blue Calming Cream After Retinol. That's what I use in my routine, too. So, top 10 Centella products. You guys are full of good ideas and more work. I like it because I've got nothing but time on my hands. So I'm going to add that to my list too. I love top 10 lists. They're so fun because it really forces me to get creative and think about my favorite products. So this is interesting. In ancient Asia, tigers lay down on cicca plants to heal wounds. That is interesting. I didn't know that. It makes sense though because it's very healing. So how about azelaic acid? It's great. That one I debated putting on my list, but you know what? I should have done my top 20 favorite ingredients, but then this live stream would have went on for 5 hours because I'm sure I could talk about each ingredient for probably a half an hour each. So anyway, so I had something else that I planned to talk about today, but maybe I'll save it and do another live stream this week. What do you think, cameraman?
Let me check my schedule.
Or do you want me to talk about it now, or are you tired?
Why don't we do one tomorrow?
Okay. Or we have to do my normal video tomorrow. Maybe Friday? What about Friday?
Whatever.
Friday at 1? Friday at 1 or 2? We'll keep you posted. We'll do one Friday, because I had a fun suggestion of the BS of the beauty industry and things they do to sell products. And there's a lot on this list. And this will probably take about at least another hour and a half. So I'll save this one. We'll do another live stream Friday.
We could go live tomorrow and then just record on Friday.
Yeah. Maybe we should do it Friday. Well, I'll keep you posted. We'll figure it out. I'm just trying to think about food. Okay. Face Theory is an interesting brand. I've got to try more from them because they seem to be really affordable. And then there's another one like Babyface. Face Theory was one I want to try. And I think another one's like Babyface. So anyway, yeah, azelaic acid is great for, especially if you have acne prone skin, pigmentation issues. I should have put it on my list, but anyway, I had to pick 10. It's so hard. So, okay. Can't wait till Friday. I will keep you guys posted. What time, but probably 1 or 2. Do you guys have a preference, 1 or 2? Does it make any difference? Doesn't matter for me, so. The Paula's Choice Azelaic Acid Booster is a good one. I really like that one, too. That's a good one. Although, sometimes when you use it with other... I try to use it when I don't use any other, like, retinol or any exfoliating acids. I try and just use azelaic acid on its own. Because sometimes it can be a bit much when you use it with other actives. So, okay. Okay, guys, thank you so much. This was so fun. I could keep talking all day, but I'll let you guys get back to eating in your skincare routines. And I'll see you guys again Friday. So, au revoir. Okay, thank you, guys. I'll see you Friday.